Welcome to Learn the Sky, your go-to resource to help you find the constellations in the night sky. We hope that you continue to go outside, observe the stars, and share what you have learned with others. If you like what you see here, be sure to click the subscribe button below. My name is Janine, and in this video, we will review how to find the constellation called Virgo. This constellation is classified as a zodiacal one, which means that the sun passes through it at some point throughout the year. If we take a look at this picture, you are looking directly at Virgo, and some of the bright stars that stand out can be used to help you find this constellation. Virgo is not a particularly bright constellation, but it is very large and easy to find. It is the second largest constellation in the sky, and it can be seen during the spring months in the northern hemisphere. Its main bright star is called Spica, and it's this bright blue star that's situated right here. This star tends to outshine all of the rest of the stars in the constellation pattern. So let's go ahead and take a look at what this pattern looks like. This is one version of the pattern of Virgo. And if you didn't pick out this shape in the earlier photo, it's totally okay. Don't worry. When I go outside and observe this constellation, Spica is really the only star that I see in the entire constellation. The rest of the stars tend to just fade out into the background. But this ends up being a very good thing because Virgo is so dim. There are a lot of other celestial objects like galaxies that will shine through this constellation. So Virgo is really known for all the celestial objects that are situated inside of its boundaries rather than the bright stars that are associated with the pattern. The best way to find Virgo is to use the Big Dipper in the larger constellation of Ursa Major, and you use the handle to arc to Arcturus and speed to Spica. And if you can remember that phrase, arc to Arcturus and speed to Spica, you should be able to find where the rest of Virgo sits. Just remember that Spica is the only really bright star in the constellation, and the rest of the stars are pretty faint. And Arcturus, Spica, and Regulus make up the asterism called the spring triangle. And this is just another tool you can use to help find these constellations. You can also use Ursa Major to point downwards to help you find Leo. Regulus is often called the heart of the lion. So again, you arc to Arcturus and speed to Spica. Let's take a closer look at the constellation pattern of Virgo and see how all the other constellations surround it and how you can use those constellations to help you find it. So Virgo has her head here, her two arms, and her two legs. And if you don't find this pattern, it's okay. Like I said, Spica is really the only bright star in this constellation. And Spica represents an ear of wheat that she is holding right here. And we won't go into the mythology of this constellation, but Virgo is known to represent many of the female deities in past ancient mythologies. And that's all I'll say for now because her mythology is quite extensive. But here we're just going to focus on how to find the constellation. So if you can find where Arcturus is by using the Big Dipper, you arc to Arcturus and speed to Spica, you should be able to easily find this constellation. And then in front of Virgo, you have a small portion of Leo right here, and this bright star is called Denebola. Okay, and then Libra is behind the constellation of Virgo. And if we wanted to take a look at where the sun passes through, this is where the ecliptic runs through. So the ecliptic, as a reminder, is a path of the sun. Now I want to give you some practice on how to find Virgo. So when we look at this picture, maybe you're not going to point out a lot of patterns in the beginning, but you want to take a closer look. Hopefully you can find at least one pretty bright star that stands out from the rest. And then the other star pattern you want to look for is the Big Dipper. Okay, remember that the Big Dipper is an asterism. It's a smaller star pattern in the bigger constellation known as Ursa Major. So if you can find the Big Dipper in this photo, you should be able to find Virgo. So let's point it out here. So here is where the Big Dipper is. Okay. So you use the handle of the Big Dipper to arc to Arcturus, and then you speed to Spica. So again, you arc to Arcturus, and then you speed to Spica. So this whole area is all Virgo. So a very large portion of the sky. And if you know where Virgo is, perhaps you can find where Leo is. Let's go ahead and trace out where these constellations are so you're not too lost as you're looking at it. So here we'll backtrack. This is the Big Dipper in the bigger constellation known as Ursa Major. So you arc to Arcturus and then you speed to Spica. Here's another version of what the constellation pattern may look like. Remember that patterns can vary from culture to culture and country to country. So we arc to Arcturus and we speed to Spica. And then here is where Leo is. Here is where Leo is. And just as a quick review, you can use the Big Dipper to help you find Polaris, which is the North Star that never moves. And then you can also use the pointer stars to help you find Leo. Okay, so keep in mind this is a very large portion of the sky, and use this as practice to help you find Virgo. Now that you're familiar with the pattern of Virgo, let's take a look at the bright stars that are situated within this constellation. And in reality, Spica is the only bright star that stands out in this entire constellation, so we're going to focus there. Spica is Latin for ear of wheat, which is why you often find Virgo depicted holding a grain of wheat. And this star is not one star, but actually two stars that are situated 260 light years away. So these close binary stars are blue giant stars, which means they're very large, they're very bright, and they're very hot. And they orbit each other every 4 days. And the sizes of them vary. One of the stars is about 10 times the mass of the sun and 7 times the sun's radius, where the other star is only 7 times the mass of the sun and 3.6 times the sun's radius. So they're both larger than the sun, but one is bigger than the other. And the more massive of the two is likely to explode into a supernova later on in its life. So this is a very interesting system that we've got going on that's very different from our own solar system. So to do a final review on Virgo, Virgo is best seen during the spring months, and it's classified as a zodiacal constellation, which means that the sun passes through it at some point during the year. The best way to find it is to use the handle of the Big Dipper to arc to Arcturus and speed to Spica. It's not a very bright constellation. It's pretty dim. There's only that bright star Spica that stands out in the entire large constellation in the sky. But there are lots of celestial objects to see. Every red dot on here is some sort of galaxy that is waiting to be observed by you. So thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions, be sure to leave them in the comments below. And remember, go outside. Keep observing the stars and share what you have learned with others. We hope to see you back soon. Thank you.